agenda, the small-scale family farm, the latest of the world's technological marvels, and the beauty and power of nature and life collide to form what is arguably our nation's most important industry. But when we break down how we're able to maintain this ever-shifting balance, one thing is clear. We must work with and not against nature. It is when we are able to marry the beautiful natural complexity of Earth with our own intentions, passion, and dedication, are we able to lay the foundations of a successful agricultural drive. There is no better example of this than the Apis mellifera, more commonly known as the European honeybee. The honeybee is at the forefront of Canadian agriculture. So many of our crops rely on the honeybee for pollination. However, in recent years, the honeybee has faced a threat. Colony collapse disorder is destroying our honeybees and threatens to unstabilize the glorious structure of Canadian agriculture. The greatest issue facing Canadian agriculture today is the continuous loss of honeybees in Canada. Honorable judges, audience, and fellow speakers, to be or not to be. That is why I am before you today. When the term honeybee comes to mind, the thing that most people think of is honey. However, honey plays a very small role when it comes to how important these insects actually are. Pollination from the European honeybee is valued at $2 billion annually in Canada. For example, Canada is the world's second largest producer of blueberry crops, with 35,000 bee colonies being used to pollinate Canada's blueberries each year. Similarly, Canada is the world's largest producer of canola, with 80,000 of Canadian bee colonies being used in canola pollination. In addition to this, 12,000 colonies are used each year to allow researchers to cross-pollinate specific strains of canola and genetic development over vast quantities with incredible accuracy. The Canadian canola industry is a $19 billion industry, which produces canola for oils, livestock feed, and biofuels. However, while blueberries and canola may be the major crops that rely on bees, food crops all over the world depend on them. In fact, one out of every three of bites of food that you take is brought to you by none other than the honeybee. However, honeybees in Canada and all over the world are facing an unknown threat. Would you not agree that something needs to be done? This threat has been placed under the blanket term of colony collapse disorder. While there are many theories, no one is sure about why bees are dying, but they are. In the winter of 2013 to 2014, honeybee losses increased from 19 to 25% in Canada, meaning that 1 in 4 Canadian bee colonies did not survive the winter. In Ontario, this percentage was 58%, perhaps the highest in Canadian history. This figure should not be this high. The problem here is that we have as of yet been unable to determine exactly what is killing the bees. There are leads and theories, however, no concrete evidence has been able to point in a single direction. General consensus is that there are a variety of factors causing this issue. However, these are so complex that no single thing can be isolated as a cause. Diseases and pests, the Canadian climate, and pesticide use are the three major groups of issues that beekeepers have been facing in Canada and all over the world. One such example is the varroa mite. The varroa mite is a small mite with a descriptive and notably accurate scientific name of varroa destructor. It's a vampiric mite which feeds on the hemolymph of adult and larvae bees, hemolymph being their equivalent to blood. The European honeybee is not the natural host of this mite, and the mite is easily able to kill them, whereas the mite's natural host bee species is able to survive with the mite on them. An infestation of varroa mites can kill an entire hive. There are several chemicals available for the treatment of varroa mite. However, this year, every province in Canada has reported a buildup in resistance to these pesticides. On top of this, the chemical treatment of hives is very hard on the colony themselves, weakening and sometimes even killing the bees. Another recent shock to the bees has been the rise and somewhat fall of neonicotinoid use. While there is no solid direct correlation between honeybee loss and the pesticides, there has been sufficient evidence to cause the province of Ontario to put forth an effort to reduce neonicotinoid use by 80% in the next several years. When we are dealing with something as valuable and as delicate as the honeybee, perhaps it is good to take precautions. Remember that our ecosystem depends on the congruency of nature and man. So our goal should not be to eliminate all pesticides, nor should it be to keep them full scale, but to achieve a balance. Honeybees are dying at alarming rates. This is the biggest threat to Canadian agriculture today. The basis of our agricultural system is dying, and no one can isolate why. Right now, in the midst of this storm, we need to look to the bees for guidance. Like them, we need to stand together united. The researchers, the farmers, the beekeepers. Only working together can we face this issue. To be or not to be? That is my question for you. Thank you.